Hey, it's Callum from the Good Edit Club, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to transform your footage from something like this to this really interesting thermal vision effect. And what we're going to use is this Hyperscope LUT pack from our store. So if you're looking to create a trippy, experimental visual style, then this pack of over 100 different LUTs inspired by infrared and thermal vision cameras are going to be really great for your project to give that a touch of artistic flair to your work. It's going to help you push the boundaries of what's possible and bring your creative vision to life. So without further ado, let's get into how we can install these LUTs and Photoshop gradients which come with this pack. So I'm going to show you how to install these LUTs on a Mac. And if you're on a Windows PC, that's absolutely fine. What I've done is I've linked below a description on how you can install those in a very similar way. Once you've downloaded Hyperscope, whether it be the free sample pack that we have on the store or the premium version, it's going to look pretty much the same. You're going to have your LUTs and you're going to have the Photoshop gradients.grd file. And what you want to do is navigate to your applications folder, which should be in your favorites bar here. If it's not, you just need to go up to Go, Computer, Macintosh HD, and you'll see the applications folder there. Double click it and find the version of Premiere Pro which you're currently using. So I'm using 2023. You need to make sure that you don't have Premiere Pro open, so make sure that it's closed first. I'm gonna right click on the application itself and go Show Package Contents. This will show me the hidden files in there, and inside Contents, I want to navigate to Lumetri. Now in here, you'll see different folders related to Lumetri Color, but we're gonna use the LUTs folder. And within this folder, you'll see that there are three more: creative, legacy, and technical. Technical is where you're going to store all your color space conversion LUTs, but we're going to import our Hyperscope LUTs into the creative folder because this is where we'll store all the artistic and style LUTs. Now, if we go to our download folder, you can see that in the cube folder, we've got different categories of LUTs. And these are basically how we've grouped the different looks depending on the predominant hue. So I'm going to use the multi LUTs today. I'm just going to install these, and you can see there's quite a lot. As I said, there's over 100 unique LUTs in here. So the possibilities are pretty much endless. There's so many different ways to tweak them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of these. I'm going to hold Alt and I'm going to drag over to the LUTs folder and make sure that I'm putting them in the creative folder. And it's going to prompt me to enter my password. And we just want to double check that it's definitely in the creative folder. Yeah, so it's in the creative folder. And now what we've done is basically installed all of the multi Hyperscope LUTs. And what we can do is close this window and head straight into Premiere Pro. Okay, so inside your new project, you want to create a new sequence. I'm just going to call this test one, and I'm just going to set this up as a 1080p sequence. I've already got a preset here, but it's just a 1920 by 1080p, 25 frames a second sequence. I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to bring in some footage. This is just some footage which I got from Pexels, and I'm just going to drag this straight into my project. Keep existing settings, and I'm going to rescale this so that it fits in my comp. So I'm going to go to Effect Controls and just scale it so it's the right size. Next, I'm going to go to Window, Workspaces, and change it to Color. This will bring up the Lumetri Color panel where I can begin to start using the Hyperscope LUTs. So inside the Lumetri Color panel, I'm just going to close Basic Correction and come straight into the Creative tab. And in the look dropdown, I'm going to select one of the Hyperscope LUTs, which you can now see have been installed. So this is Acid One. And, you know, instantly we've got a really cool look here. This is like a thermal imaging camera look. And I can use these arrows just to like swipe and preview these, the different looks that we've got available, which is a really good way of seeing and previewing before we apply. And I really love this one. This is Dion. Yeah, it's quite a, what should we say, striking, vibrant look. So it is not subtle. This is something that's really highly stylized. And the way you control this isn't by using the intensity slider, because of it being such an intense look. What you want to do is control the input. So we are going to change the light settings. So if we come here to the exposure, you can see that what actually happens isn't that the brightness of the image changes, it's the colors that are being selected. And this allows you to really dial in what colors that you want out of your LUT. So you can use the exposure, contrast, and the highlights and shadows in order to fine tune the look that you want to go for. And just to share another example, I'm gonna bring in the other clip that we imported and scale this down and come into the Lumetri color panel again, just closing the basic correction tab, going straight into creative. And I can preview all of the looks that we have here. And what I'm gonna do is pick one of my favorites, which is this one, Freak. It's a really cool one because what happens is if you push the exposure up, the highlights at some point begin to completely invert, which is one of my favorites. It kind of reminds me of like a lava, well, basically a thermal imaging camera, but in a really unique way. So yeah, this is something that you can use, but you can also add a few extra things like different effects. So if you go and find the Gaussian blur effect, you can apply that just before Lumetri color. And what it'll do is it'll take the harshness of this from highlights to the shadows, it'll start to ramp it. So if you increase the blur radius, you can see that the fall off here, it goes all the way from the blacks all the way through to the purples, instead of just the harsh edges. And this is a similar effect that you saw at the beginning. It's Brockhampton's Count On Me music video. And this is a really unique effect. It kind of reminds me a little bit of like X-ray thermal radiation scans. Yeah, it's a really cool, interesting look that you can use. Another way to get a bit experimental, this is slightly more advanced, but one thing that you can do is if you type directional blur, if you add that instead and increase the blur length, you know, already you got this really cool look, but I'm gonna just type 90 degrees in here so it goes across the screen. And if you, you know, push this all the way, all of a sudden you have this like flare effect. And if you were to maybe like speed this up, we could possibly use it as a transition as well. So what I'm gonna do is just change the speed, let's say 400%, and we get this rapid fiery flare, which is really unusual and is completely different from the footage that we started off with, but it's one way which we can use it to apply to different pieces of footage. So if I was to bring that other clip back in again, the original one, I've got this look and then this clip, which I'm going to rescale down again. Now, what I want to do is just use this as an example to show how the LUTs can be used as a cool transition as well. So what I'm gonna do is just start to trim the ends here of this clip. What I might do is just create a few cuts. And what I want to do is for some of them, just turn off the Lumetri color effect. So on this clip, I'm gonna turn Lumetri color off. Just double check that I'm affecting it, yeah. And then this clip, I'm gonna turn Lumetri color off as well. So it'll do like this stutter effect. And I'm going to do the exact same. I'm gonna make a cut there, and so on. So if I add the, well, let's say the same effect. So I'm just going to come to effect controls and copy Lumetri color and just paste it on that clip there. That one. So you have this trippy transition. Let's take a look if we just turn Lumetri color off. So it's this cool flashing of thermal energy, and it's really cool to add a little vibrancy to your edits. And what we can do as well is add in this, this almost transition that we created. I'm just gonna put it over the first half. And we can change the blending mode of it to something like screen. And we can take a look at that. Yeah, so we've got this really trippy look, which we've created with no other assets apart from the footage that we've used. And we've created something really unique here. And if we wanted to take it a step further, you know, you could even start scaling some of these clips up to get like a really unusual, distorted look. Let's take a look. Yeah, this like flash frame burn. I would call it like a modern film burn, but this is a really unique way to use some of the Hyperscope LUTs within this pack. So let's get into the Photoshop gradients and how you can use these on your designs as well. So I'm just going to set up a new document. I'm going to create a 2000 by 2000 pixel canvas and just click create. So the first thing I want to do is add some text, and I'm just going to type Hyperscope in here. And I'm just going to play around with some fonts to find one that I like. So now I've got my text, I use Transducer Condensed Bold. This is a font from Adobe Fonts. It's one that I'm really loving at the moment for anyone who's interested. And what I want to do now is to bring in those gradient maps from the Hyperscope folder. And to do that, I'm going to come down to this little icon here where it says create new fill or adjustment layer. And clicking on it will open this folder. I want to click on gradient map. What that will do is it will create a new layer called gradient map 1. What you want to do is just click on the gradient map at the top. Then if we go to import, you can see that I've already navigated. I've got the destination set as the Hyperscope volume 1.grd. This is in the Hyperscope folder. So if we click open, you'll see that those gradient maps have all been installed and they're exactly the same as the LUTs that we have as well. But what I want to do is demo some of the different looks that we have here, which we didn't have a look at in Premiere. So the one that I want to look at is, let's have a look at Stella. Okay, so if we just click OK, now you'll notice that there isn't much going on here, and that's because we've just got a two-tone image. It's a black background with white text. And what we want to do is start to incorporate the in-between. So what we can do is go to filter and add a blur effect, so Gaussian blur. And this is automatically going to take our image from something which is quite mundane to something which has what the kind of this like sci-fi neon theme. So I'm just going to leave this at 12 pixels because I like the look of that, and I'm going to hit OK. And you can even do the same with some images. So I'm going to bring in an image just like this, and I'm going to scale it up. If it's underneath the gradient map, it'll automatically work. If it isn't, you just need to bring it down. And what you can do with these gradient maps that you couldn't do with your LUTs is that you have full manual control over the different colors. So say if I wanted this to actually be completely black, I can do that if I wanted to. And if I wanted to change this blue color to, I don't know, something like a green, I could also do that. So you have this massive range of different gradient maps which you can select and use in any different project, whether that be an experimental design project or a music video that you're working on and you want to create some really cool album artwork to go with it. If you want to get your hands on the free sample, go ahead, go download it and tell your friends about it. It's a really good way to get your hands on experimenting with these LUTs. And if you want to, you can make a purchase of the premium pack and you get access to all of these different looks that you can use in your creative projects. Feel free to leave a comment below and I'll get back to you. And I always love talking to people on social media. So hit me up on TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, whatever works for you. And thank you for watching. I will catch you on the next one.